Hello, Transylvania Vision class. I'm Catherine Gresham, chair of the Division of Fine Arts at Brevard College. And I'm sorry that I can't be with you today, but I'm very pleased to have an opportunity to show you some samples of our programs in the form of a video. So I'll tell you a little bit about my programs before you see said video. We have three programs in the fine arts that serve a total of about 100 students. They are art, theater, and music. In the art major, students can concentrate in art history, sculpture, painting and drawing, photography, or time-based media. In theater, we have an all-encompassing BA program, but students study acting, directing, playwriting, scenic and lighting design, and costume design as well. Our music program is also a BA program, and we have a general BA and also a BA in music education. We also offer licensure to our art and theater students as well. So we have many, many teachers out there in the schools now. In addition to teachers, our alumni are actors at professional theaters, independent filmmakers, museum curators, adventure wedding photographers, doctors, lawyers, and the list goes on. We're very proud of our alums, and they give back to us generously. Our community partnerships are many as well. They include the Brevard Music Center, the Brevard Philharmonic Orchestra, the Brevard Community Band, the Transylvania Choral Society, the Transylvania County Arts Council, the Bascom Center in Highlands, and many others. We are definitely a small school that plays big. Our students not only have a lot of performance opportunities in our beautiful Porter Center for the Performing Arts, but they exhibit, they install sculptures around town. They go to conferences such as the National Association of Teachers of Singing auditions. We have a national finalist this year in those auditions. They go to the Percussive Arts Society International Conference, the Tri-State Sculpture Competition, and the Southeastern Theater Conference as well. So they get a really rigorous and nurturing environment at a nice small campus. So enjoy the clips we have from our theater productions, our art exhibitions, and our music concerts. And please, if you have any questions for me, give them to Angela and I will reach back out to you. Thanks.
Lindy Lou. You live in such a beautiful country, a countryside. Will you miss it?
Yes.
Me too. We'll come back once a year, so we don't forget it.
Very well.
So, all's well that ends right on the dot. Good night, everyone.
Thank you.
Well, if you ever plan to motor west, travel my way, take the highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66.
Serious woman of science and give me this paper to read. You cannot send that to the Academy.
I am serious and it is science.
You know what you are saying.
Voltaire, when energy collides with energy, they don't just cancel each other out.
How can you contradict me?
I'm not contradicting.
Your arrogance is appalling.
It's in the numbers.
The numbers don't count.
Gottfried Leibniz thinks the same way.
Gottfried Leibniz is German. Oh, don't get me started on the Germans.
When two objects collide, the forces don't cancel each other out.
Arrogance collides with naivete. Let me assure you, it risks canceling everything we are doing.
These are equations, not moral judgments.
All the work we have done to prove that this universe is based on rational mathematical law, and now you want to cast doubt on Newton's theories.
My equations are correct.
Correct isn't always what's right.
I'm a scientist, I'm not a philosopher.
You all right?
Too hot, and I'm too fat to be fighting like this.
Stop working. You have to take care of yourself.
I have to stay awake. There are pages and pages left to do.
You worry about your health and then do nothing to protect it. It's as if you are trying to make your prediction come true. You owe it to yourself, to this child, to me, to lie down and rest.
I just thought I would have more time. When the children were young, I remember thinking, when I'm older, I will have time to think all the thoughts, and read all the books, and know what I do not know, and make a contribution to the world that is singular and unique and mine. And I know it is folly to think about. I know I mustn't think that way. Who am I to assume that I have anything to contribute? But I do.
You have your children.
And I love them. But they are not me.
I feel like your puppet. You pull my strings while you play me. Why do I move with your movement? Up on your stage, I'm performing. Left you, but I'm back here on your sofa. Thought I needed space, I want you closer. So why do I move with your movement? Under your strings, like a puppet.
I'm too afraid to turn my back on this. Swear you did a number on me like some raffle tickets. Lucky you, you stuck with me, might as well tattoo that. Be like that sometimes, you show up, I be acting different. Maybe I'm crazy, but if I lose you, oh, I don't know if I survive. You drive me crazy for your amusement, and I'm alone for the price. Got me talking to myself.
The pain won't stop me, the rain won't stop me. I know God can stop me, but he ain't gonna stop me, cause he the one who got me. I don't see why my back bend.
The sailors sought for safety by our boat, then left the ship, sinking right to us. My wife, more careful for the battle-born, had fastened him onto a small spare mast, such as seafaring men provided for storms, and to him one of the other twins was bound, whilst I had been like heedful of the other. The children thus disposed, my wife and I, fixing our eyes on whom our care was fixed, fastened each other at either end of the mast, and then, floating straight, obedient to the stream, was carried towards port.
Did you have fun? That's the point of all this. Did you have fun? Good.
Wait, but you're dead. You're gone.
I know. But this story remains. And isn't that essentially all life is? A collection of stories. This was one of mine.
Not just something I experienced, like a party or a dance, but something I dreamt.
Something far more personal and important than happenstance. This story came from my soul, and by breathing life into it, who knows?
Maybe a bit of my soul gets the chance to breathe for a moment once again.
I love you, my sister.
I'm sorry I can't be there.
I have no idea why you had to experience this adventure alone without me, but I do hope it gave you a glimpse into me the way I always wanted you to see me.
Strong,
powerful,
and magical.
Congratulations, Agnes. You've completed the quest for the lost soul of Athens.
And so, Agnes the cheerleader accomplished her very first quest. And soon she would embark on another, and then another, and so on and so forth for the rest of her life. Miles, the boyfriend, who would one day become Miles, the ex-boyfriend, would join her on her many quests alongside Chuck, the big brain, and Tilly's old group of friends. Ronnie, the slacker, Kelly, the not so good legged, and Lily, the closeted. Tilly was never forgotten. Agnes grew up and always remembered fondly the day she killed monsters. The end.
Bing bong bing bing bong bong bing bong bing bing bong bing bong bing bong bing bing bong bong bing bong bing bing bong bing bing. É só isso, meu baião, e não tem mais nada, não. O meu coração pediu assim só. Só isso, meu baião, e não tem mais nada, não. O meu coração pediu assim só. Bim bom, bim bim bom, bom, bim bom, bim bim bom, bim bom.
Seventeenth last,
and she was found dead by you in the bleeding bath the following bleeding day.
Yes, quite right.
He agreed. You're also said to be identical with another George Joseph Smith, whose little trouble and strife wife, Alice, was found in similar circumstances.
He denied it.
Smith? I'm not Smith. I don't know what you're talking about.
Any question of further charges is a matter for inquiry.
He kept talking.
The two deaths do form a phenomenal coincidence, eh? But that's just my hard luck.
On the way to the police station, Smith admitted.
It is the irony of fate that my two wives should have died in this way. Fate, John?
There's nothing ironic about that, George.
Don't you mean three, Henry?
May it please you, it must be noted
that the three cases are of such a character
that the resemblances cannot have occurred without design.
In Alice's case?
In Margaret's case?
In Bessie's case?
In each case, the woman is swept off her feet.
And the woman is considered vulnerable.
The woman's life is insured.
A counterfeit marriage takes place.
The woman's isolated from her family.
All the woman's ready money was realized.
The woman makes a will in the husband's favor.
The property could only be got at in the event of the woman's death.
There were inquiries about a bathtub.
There were unnecessary visits to a doctor.
The husband was the first to discover the body.
There were no signs of violence on any of the victims. No bruises, no lacerations. Not even the sounds of a struggle were heard.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching all those clips. If you're still with us, I thought I'd tell you about a few upcoming performances we have at the college. Tonight, Thursday, April 21st, there's a wind ensemble concert in the Porter Center at 7:30. They will be hosting the Blue Ridge Symphonic Brass as guests. Sunday, we have our BC Choral Concert at 3 o'clock in the Porter Center. And on Wednesday of next week, the 27th, we have what's called BC Theater Mixtape, which will be a showcase of our stage combat class, our playwriting class, and some other things. That's at 7 o'clock in the Morrison Playhouse. Bye-bye.